It's time for another episode of The Sean Tabbitt Show, a podcast where I connect you with thought leaders from across the globe, digging into some of my favorite topics like personal development, marketing, spirituality, and pretty much any other shiny object that happens to catch my attention. Today, my special guest is my good friend Kevin Zadai, and this time around, we're going to be talking about his book, Praying from the Heavenly Realms, Supernatural Secrets to a Lifestyle of Answered Prayer. Kevin, welcome back to the show.
Sean, I am so excited about this new book. Good to talk to you.
As we talked about right before we got started, it's like a double blessing in my life to get to have you record with me twice in 1 week. So thanks for making the time. I greatly appreciate it.
Yes, sir. My pleasure.
In our last interview, I had you kind of give us a refresher of who you are for the listeners that hadn't met you before. This time around, I wanted to start with your foreword. So the foreword of this book is written by Dr. Jesse Duplantis, and he's somebody who's become an important figure in your life, kind of a mentor in your life, and would love to just hear the story of how you two got connected. And I know God's brought you guys together for some different ministry things. So tell me about your relationship with him and why he's important to you.
Yes, Sean, it's really important to me to have relationships. I found that when I did have this experience years ago with Jesus, one of the most important things I saw was how men and women of God on the earth, they can hand off and impart to you. And so it was very important to me when I saw what Jesus did to his disciples by making disciples, imparting to them, and then leaving them alone, but giving the Holy Spirit as their help, that I saw that we could do anything through the Holy Spirit. But I also saw that there was men and women on the earth that walked in great authority and understanding. So when I came back, it was as though things were just set up for me. I started meeting these amazing people. Jesse Duplantis was one of those. I was told by the Holy Spirit and my wife, we both were told to start visiting down here in New Orleans. And we would just rent a hotel and we would pray for a whole week in the hotel. We would just lock ourselves in. We did that for 3 months straight. So we worked full-time jobs. We lived in Phoenix, Arizona and in Seattle. And we came down and just fasted and prayed. And we didn't even know what was going to happen. But on the third month, we met Jesse Duplantis on a tour of his ministry, and our hands locked and we shook, and God just moved in a strong way. So he was spoken to by the Lord, said, "This man I've sent to you." And he took me to TBN. He called Jan Crouch and people like that. And before you know it, Sid Roth saw the show with me and Jesse. And before you know it, I'm on Sid Roth, and Jesse Duplantis has become my spiritual father. He has ordained me and my wife. They're both, Kathy and Jesse Duplantis, are precious to us. But God did this, and God could do that for people that are listening. God will set you up, and there's people that have already paved the way. And these two are my life for a very special reason.
That's a great story. Thank you for giving us the background about that important relationship. It's always interesting to hear sometimes the prayer and the fasting and the time and the work that gets put in before God will, in his timing, open up a door or a relationship. So that's really interesting. Thank you for that. Next, let's get into what I like to call the story behind the book. I'm ever curious about, you know, what's the catalyst? What's the spark that gets an author moving in a particular direction? So for Praying from the Heavenly Realms, where did this book get its start? What pushed you in the direction of writing this?
Well, Sean, everything that I do is birthed in prayer or some sort of encounter with the Holy Spirit. Every book that I've ever written has been a mandate from heaven. And this one in particular, me and my wife got this idea in prayer one morning, and we were praying in the Spirit. And my wife looked at me and she said, "Kevin, you're supposed to write a book on prayer. That's your track with the Holy Spirit. That's your track with the Lord. You just understand prayer. Jesus taught you a lot about prayer." And so I said, "You know, you are right. I'm going to go up and I'm just going to start writing." So I literally left the conversation and the prayer time, went up to my office and wrote the first chapter, which is called Getting Heaven's Attention. As soon as I flipped my laptop over, I finished it in an hour, that chapter, my phone rang and it was Sid Roth. And he said, "Kevin, God just spoke to me and said, you're supposed to write a book on prayer." And he said, "I already know the name of it." And he said, "The Lord told me to help you in any way to get this thing out. So I'm going to be calling a publisher." And that's how this book was birthed, Sean. It was supernatural. Sid Roth actually told me the title of the book and knew about it before we had even spoken.
Wow, that's great confirmation. And I will say, if this is the original title that Sid got from the Lord, it's as somebody who works in the publishing industry, it's a fabulous title. So, also
Yes.
another fun story. One of the important questions that you tackle in the book, and this is actually one of your chapter titles, it's why aren't my prayers being answered? And I think throughout my life and friends, family, people I know, we all have prayers that don't get answered. And so we all will question this and ask this from time to time. What are some of the things that can hinder us from receiving answers to prayer?
Well, Sean, it's a good question. The fact of it is that we don't know what we should pray for. And Jesus is one of those people who spoke about how if we were connected with him through the word, so if the word of God abided in us, and we were in him and the word abided in him, that we could ask what we will. He spoke about this in John 15 and in John chapter 14. So my question to people is this is, well, what would you do if you would get everything answered? If you ask God for something, you would get it answered. I said, how would you act then? Most people say, well, then I'd be really careful about what I ask for. I said, exactly. I said, so I always bring people back to the key is to know the word of God, to know the revealed will of God that's already in his word. And so Jesus taught me to teach people to pray according to the word and get a good base. It's the same thing with when I was in flight training. I learned how to just fly straight and level because that's something that you could do pretty easily. After that, they build you up in other ways to do other maneuvers and things like that. But you focus on what you know is sure. And I'm telling you, Sean, there's so much in the Bible that you could pray for that's already revealed. And then that builds your confidence. You start to see your prayers being answered when you ask for wisdom. So I recommend that people start to pray. Chapter 1 of Ephesians, verse 17 through 23. Paul talks about the eyes of your heart being enlightened, that you would have a spirit of wisdom and revelation and knowledge of him. I start there, and that's how I train people. That's what Jesus taught me, is to pray the prayers that are already in the Bible. And so I've seen a lot of results with people. They're starting to get their prayers answered. And I'm telling you, there's so much in the Word of God that we could pray for. And one of those things, like I said, is your eyes being opened. That's the biggest deal, is to have discernment and to know. And the praying in the Spirit is another way. You pray in the Spirit, and it starts to lock you in on God's will.
My follow-up question is, what's the role of the Holy Spirit in our prayer life? I know some people don't always equate the Holy Spirit's work with prayer life and answer to prayer, but that's actually something that's critically important. So talk to us about that.
Yeah, it's so important because in Romans 8:26, Paul talked about the fact that the Holy Spirit in our weakness, not in our strength, but in our weakness, the Holy Spirit comes in and grabs a hold of us. He takes hold of us and he causes us to pray out the mysteries or pray out the will of God. And there's a perfect will of God in heaven. And so you see the Holy Spirit starting to take you into a center position with God, where you get in alignment in the center of his will. The Holy Spirit wants to start to pray those things out. So the Holy Spirit actually can take hold of you. So baptism of the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in tongues is very important. And Jesus spoke a lot about this with me in my visitation that I had in 1992. In fact, he spent 20 minutes of the 45 talking about words and prayer in the Spirit as being very important.
Next, let's transition into how can heavenly visitations become a more normal part of our prayer life? Would love to have you comment about visitations from angels. I know based into my own prayer experiences and having read your books and others, you know, people have had visitation experiences with Jesus. So once we get deeper, go further down the path with our prayer life, renewing our mind as you've been describing, how can that open up visitations and that might become a more normal part of our prayer life?
Well, Sean, one of the most important things to Jesus personally that I've learned in a lot of the encounters that I've had is that he wants to develop an intimate relationship with every believer. And in order to do that, there has to be a renewing of the mind that happens in Romans 12, too. But there also has to be this time of waiting on the Lord and allowing the Holy Spirit to move in the times of prayer. and the revelation of the Holy Spirit. He's a person that actually comes alongside you and assists you. He's also inside of you as well. And so there's this process where you have to realize that when you engage God by reading His Word, praying in the Spirit, meditating, all these different things, that it is an interaction with the heavenly realms. And so you have to realize that there are things that you're going to do that are going to get heaven's attention. And so we need to focus on those things. Now, one of those things, like I mentioned, is your words. When you speak, you should speak as though you're speaking the very oracles of God, is what Paul said. And there's other things like what the Holy Spirit starts to move on you strongly, and you feel an utterance. You feel like you should go a certain direction in prayer. Well, what happens is you don't know it, but angels start to come in because they're sent to minister for those who are going to inherit salvation, according to the book of Hebrews. So we have this interaction with the heavenly realm and the prophetic side of the Holy Spirit, where there's a movement of revelation and you start to speak from that place. Angels actually come and stand with you because you're speaking by the Spirit. And people, they have to get to the place where, listen, if I'm going to pray, God's going to hear me, because He always hears you. When children pray, the Heavenly Father hears you and He is going to answer you in some way. But that could be a visitation or an encounter. But the Holy Spirit is always present. And I teach people, listen, in this book, I teach them how when you pray, you better believe heaven is listening, because you are a child of God on this earth and you have great authority. God looks at you as being someone who is purchased, and the name of Jesus is very powerful in a believer's life.
As we begin to wrap up here, Kevin, just a couple of closing questions. When you say, think of a reader getting to the last page of praying from the heavenly realms, what's the big message you hope they've heard loud and clear? And how do you hope their Christian walk, their Christian life has shifted? How would you like to see them different from when they just started reading the book?
Well, Sean, that's the most important question to me, because when I was sent back, Jesus told me to tell people what I saw, what I heard. I was at the throne of God, and I actually saw what Jesus talks about when he was talking to John in the book of Revelation. He said that those who overcome will sit with me on a throne. And that is a similar kind of language that Paul talked about in the Ephesians, where Ephesians 2:5 says that we are seated with him in the heavenly realms. Sean, I got to sit on that throne beside Jesus, and I felt uncomfortable. But that's what I want people to take away from this book, is that there is a spot, according to what Jesus said in the book of Revelation to John, there is a seat. There is a place for you to sit in authority with him, and that we are to pray from that authority. And that's what I want people to take away from the book. And I believe I walk them through that, through those chapters.
Kevin, thank you for giving us an overview of what we're going to encounter when we read Praying from the Heavenly Realms. I also wanted to have you take a moment to comment about your new school. This is something we talked about last time, but if this is the interview people are picking up for the first time and meeting you, we'd be doing them a disservice if we didn't mention it here as well. So tell us about the exciting developments you've had in the past few weeks with your new school.
Yes, Sean. The Lord instructed me that He did not want me to just come to different places and teach, and then there's like a drive-by in a way. He wanted me to create an atmosphere of discipleship. So I did this school, Warrior Notes School of Ministry. You can just log on to my website, kevinzadi.com, and there's a tab for Warrior Notes School of Ministry. This ministry school is preparing people to walk in everything that Jesus taught me. So I have classes on there on all different subjects. And just so you know, we have slated to have, by the end of next year, we will have 32 different classes on there available. And this is what Jesus told me to do. He said, Kevin, he said, replicate the ministry that I gave you, replicated to people, because it's the ministry of Jesus. So that's what I do, Sean. I'm just replicating Jesus.
Well, Kevin, congratulations on the ministry school. It's exciting. Just the success you've seen already and how many students have signed up. Like we do with every episode, we'll have detailed links in the show notes, places where you can connect with Kevin, pick up copies of his various books, and find out more about the school. We'll also have links to my earlier conversations with Kevin right there as well. So when you're all done, head on over to seantabbitt.com. It'll be all right there for you. It's time to bring this episode of the Sean Tabbitt Show to a close. Many thanks for being a part of my conversation with Kevin Zadai. Once again, our book today was Praying from the Heavenly Realms, Supernatural Secrets to a Lifestyle of Answered Prayer. Again, if you'd like to connect with Kevin and find out more, a great place to start is his website. And once again, you'll be able to access that at kevinzadai.com. That's KevinZadai.com. And Kevin, I just want to say thanks so much for sharing with us today. It's been a great pleasure and an honor to have you back on the show.
Thank you, Sean.